So, in your textbook, this is the third question. Draw the graph of the given polynomial, find the zeros and justify the answers. This is a graphical method of finding the zeros of the polynomial. So, this is x square minus x minus 2. For graphical method, you take this as y because graph will have x and y only. So don't write, this given polynomial is taken as y. Now we have to prepare a table. See here. X, y. What is y? X square minus x minus 12. See, in the last class I explained you, take this as x and this is y, x, y coordinates. So take any x values, take any x values, 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, any numbers you take. So I will take minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, let me take one more number, 2, any numbers you take, no problem. So, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, I am taking. I will take these numbers. If we you can take any x values, why you should not raise a question, why you took minus 2? Any x values we can take. But finding y value is important. Substitute that x in the function, in the polynomial and get the y value. So, x is equal to minus 2. What is y? See here. What is y? Take x is equal to minus 2. What is y? So, see here. Minus 2 whole square minus of minus 2 minus 12. How much? See, minus 2 here. Minus 2 whole square minus of minus 2 minus 12. 2 square is 4. Minus whole square plus 4. Minus into minus plus 4 plus 2. 4 plus 2, 6, 6 minus 2 is minus 6. So we got minus 6. Y value minus. Take minus 1. Take minus 1 and get y value. Y is equal to minus 1 whole square minus of minus 1 minus 12. Minus into minus plus 1 minus 1 whole square. 1 plus 1, 2 minus 10 is the second value. Take x is equal to 0. 0 square x value 0 minus 12 is minus 12. Take x is equal to 1. 1. 1 I am taking. See here. 1. So y is equal to 1 square minus 1 minus 12. 1 square is 1, 1 minus 1 minus 0, this is minus 12. 0 we took, we got minus 12, 1 also we are getting minus 12. And take 2, 2 square is 4, minus 10. Like this, take any x values, any x value you can take, 0, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, any numbers. Substitute that x value in the given polynomial, get the corresponding y values. Minus 6 we got, minus 10 we got, minus 12 we got, minus 12 we got. And take x is equal to 2 and substitute, we will get minus 10. So these are the points. X value, first we write x value. So minus 2 minus 6 is first point. Second point is minus 1 minus 10. So third point is 0 minus 12. Fourth point is 1 minus 12. Fifth point is 2 minus 10. Like this we got 5 points. And representing on the graph, see here, y axis, x axis. Graph is also not new to you. You know how to draw the graph. Horizontal line is x axis. Vertical line is y axis. I will take This is of course 0, 0, you know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 11, minus 12. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, so on, like this. Take the graph paper. Take the graph paper and write the equal distance of numbers. Now first point, minus 2, minus 6. X value minus 2. See here, x value means on x-axis. X value minus 2. This is x-axis. X value minus 2, y value minus 6. Minus 2, y value on y-axis. So minus 6. This is the point. X value minus 2, y value minus 6, this is the point. Same way, x value minus 1, y value minus 10. See here, x value minus 1, y value minus 10. This is one point. X value 0, y value minus 12. X value 0 means on y axis only. X value 0, y value minus 12, this is the point. X value 1, y value minus 12. X value 1, y value minus 12. This is the point. X value 2, y value minus 10. X value 2, y value minus 10. This is approximately, this is the point. So even in 8th and 9th class also, you studied how to locate the points on the coordinate system. This is the x-axis. Take the value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 on x-axis. Minus 1, minus 2. Y values. And plot the points, x value minus 2, y value minus 6 means minus 2, minus 6, this is the point. So if you join this, you will get like this. Plot the points and if you take the graph paper, you will get exact figure. So, because this is not a graph paper, we will get approximately. But on the graph paper, you can draw exactly. So, this graph will be like this. If you take it on the graph paper, the graph will be like this. This is the graph. This is a graph of given polynomial. You will get like this. Write this diagram and draw this diagram and write down this table and everything. Write down fast and I will give some explanation and I will give the answer. Draw the diagram and write down this table and all. after writing everything, the graph of given polynomial meets or cuts the x-axis at what point, there are those points are the answers, that's all. So wherever this graph is cutting the x-axis, those are the answers. But if you take the graph paper, you will get the exact answer. If you write only on the plain paper, you won't get the exact value. So if you draw the curve on the graph paper, so this graph will meet the x-axis at 4 and here at x-axis at minus 3. So wherever the graph is cutting the x-axis at the points, so those are the answers. So what are the answers? Minus 3 and 4, these are the answers. 4 and minus 3. So these are the answers. Wherever the graph is cutting the x-axis, those points are the answers. Minus 3 and 4 are the answers. Even you can check by our ordinary method. Simple method, take it and factorize, you will get x values. You will get minus 3 and 4 only. So draw the graph. And even to verify whether these are correct answers or not, to verify, if you take x is equal to minus 3, we should get 0. So we are getting 0 here. Minus 3 all square is 9, minus into minus plus 3, 9 plus 3, 12 minus 12 is 0. Same if you take 4 also, it is also 0. See, x is equal to 4. Minus 4 minus 12. 4 square is 16 minus 4. 12, 12 minus 12 is 0. So therefore, when the answer is 0, they are the zeros of the polynomial. So x axis at minus 3 comma 4. Therefore, these are the zeros of the polynomial. Zeros of the polynomial are these values. Zeros of the polynomial are minus 3 comma 4. And verify also, I took minus 3 and 4, we got 0, say therefore these are the answers. This is a graphical method, and of course graphical method will be difficult only, because drawing the graph, you don't have much practice. Of course you studied some graphs in 8th class and 9th class, but only little, not much practice. So formula method and factorizing method very easy, but graphical method is somewhat difficult. So you only three, four problems are there, only one question is there, in that we have 4 bits. So if you practice, that is sufficient. So I explained, but you have to draw on the graph paper, then only you will get exact values, minus 3 and 4. Same process you apply for one more problem. First, I will take the simple one. X square minus 1, 5th bit. Prepare the table and try to start. Prepare the table. Prepare the table for this. X square minus 1, take it as y and prepare the table. Take any x values. For example, you take minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. These values, you can take these values. So take that values and prepare the table. Minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. X square minus 1 graph, take it as y and prepare the table. For preparing the table, for finding xy coordinates, take any x values, whatever you want you can take, but it should be convenient. We can, if you take 100, so 100 number we cannot represent in the graph, only small values, 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, like that near values you should take. So I am drawing the, I am preparing the table. So the table is, see here, x values you take and find the y values and prepare the table. Take any x values. I will take say minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Say for example, I took these values. Any x values you can take. Find the corresponding y values. Find the y values and prepare the coordinates. And represent on the graph and get the, draw the graph. Take any x values. I am taking minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Substitute here. Minus 2. Y is equal to x value minus 2. X value minus 2, x value minus 1, x value 0, get the y values and fill the second row. Fill this. Minus 2 whole square is 4 minus 1, 3, minus 2, 3, 1 point we got. Take minus 1, minus 1 whole square minus 1, 1 square is 1 minus 1 is 0. So I took minus 1 and I got 0, so this is 1 point I got. Take x is equal to 0. X is equal to 0, that is 0 square minus 1, so minus 1. X is 0 and I got minus 1. So 0 comma minus 1. Take x values, any x values. So again I am explaining why I took these values. Any values we can take. Substitute those values in x, in the place of x, and get the y values. 3, 0, minus 1. Take 1 and get the value. Take 1 and get the value. Take 1. X value 1 square minus 1 is 0. So 0 we are getting, 1 comma 0. Take 2. We will get 3. These are the points we got. And take the graph paper and draw the x axis with the help of the scale. Draw the y axis with the help of the scale. Take any value, say this is of course 0, 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. See here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Like that you take some values and plot the points on the plane. Plot the points on the system. Minus 2, 3. See here. X value minus 2, y value 3. 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 X value minus 1, y value 0. X value minus 1. X value minus 1, y value 0 means, x value minus 1, y value 0 means on x axis only. X value minus 1, y value 0. This is the point. X value minus 1, there is no y value, that is 0 only. So that means that point only. X value minus 1, y value 0. X value 0, y value minus 1. X 0, y minus 1, see here. This is the point. Say this is P1. Say this will be P2. Say this is P3. Some representation. Next, x value 1, y value 0. X 1, y 0. This is the point. X 2, y 3. X 2, y 3. X 2, y 3. So, if you draw the graph, we are getting the graph like this. That is the graph approximately.
The function is y is equal to x square minus 1. The polynomial is y is equal to x square minus 1. Graph is like this.
Draw the graph, write down the table. Write the table and draw the graph. Write down this table and draw this graph. So where the graph is cutting the x-axis, if you draw the on graph paper, we will get exact values as per this diagram, and even exact value also. So the graph is cutting the x-axis at minus 1 and plus 1. See here, the graph of y is equal to x square minus 1 cuts the x-axis or meets the x-axis, same meaning. Cuts the x-axis at what points? Minus 1 and plus 1. These are our answers. Minus 1, plus 1 are our answers. So therefore, minus 1, comma, plus 1 are zeros of the polynomial. Zeros of this polynomial. Answer is minus 1, plus 1. Even you can verify, take minus 1 and plus 1, we will get the answer 0 only. Take a p of minus 1 and p of plus 1, both will be 0. So see here, x square minus 1 whole square minus 1, 1 square is 1 minus 1, 0. Take plus 1, so this is 0. So therefore, answers are 0 means minus 1 and plus 1 are the zeros of the polynomial. This is I verified, that's all. So this is the graphical method. We have total 5 bits. One more I will give, I will solve. Remaining you can do. That's all. Write the third one and prepare the table. Third one. Write the third one, x square minus 4x plus 5. X square minus 4x plus 5. Take this as y and prepare the table. Prepare the table by taking any x values, find the corresponding y value. Take any x value. Say x value minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, something, any values you can take. Even if you want, you can take minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. Take any x values and find the y values. Fill this table. Fill that table. Take x values and find corresponding y values. Fill this table. Substitute the y x values and get the y values. You do it. See, don't write. I will give the hint and you do afterward. Take x is equal to minus 2. Minus 2 whole square is 4.
4 into 2, 8, 13, 18. Minus 2 whole square is 4 plus 4 into minus 2, 8 plus 5, 17. Next, if you take minus 1 whole square is plus 1 plus 4 plus 5. Do it. Do yourself. Substitute the value in place of x, get the y values. This is 5. This is 2. This is 1. This is 2. Prepare the table. Take x is equal to minus 2. Minus 2 whole square is 4 plus 8. 12 plus 5 is 17. Minus 1 whole square is minus 1 plus 1. 1 plus 5 6 plus 4 10. Take 0, 0, 0 only 5. Take 1. 1 plus 5 6 minus 4 is 2. Take 2, 2 square 4 plus 5 9. Minus 8, 1. Take 3, 3 square is 9, 9 plus 5, 14, minus 4 into 2, 8, 9 minus 8 is 1. Take x is equal to 3, 3 square minus 4 into 3 plus 5, 3 square is 9 minus 12 plus 5, 9 plus 5, 9 plus 5, 14 minus 2 is 2 only. Now, see, don't write, I will draw the graph and you do it afterwards. See here, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so on, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, so on. See here, minus 2, 17. X value minus 2, Y value 17, somewhere here. So, you take the points and you do it. X value minus 1, Y value 10. Minus 1 and 10 somewhere here. X value 0, Y value 5. 0, 5. X value 1, Y value 2. X value 1, Y value 2. X value 2, Y value 1. X value 3, Y value 2, don't write. So approximately if you draw the curve, you will get like this. This is a rough figure, you get the exact by from the graph. This is the graph you are getting. It is not meeting the x-axis. This graph not cutting the x-axis. It is not cutting the x-axis. So therefore, zeros of the polynomial does not exist. Zeros of the polynomial does not exist. Does not exist. So no zero of the polynomial. It should meet at, if it is meeting at one point, that is answer. If it is meeting at two points, two answers. Maximum two only, because second degree means it will have two answers maximum. So here, if it is meeting at two points, two answer, at one point, one answer, not meeting, no answers, no answers, no zeros of the, does not exist. So zero of the polynomial does not exist. If you draw this by using the graph, you will get the idea. So, three problems I solved, same three problems, you practice using the graph and get the idea. So, that's all. Only one problem, only these five problems based on graph and remaining is normal procedure only. So, this is only difficult. Otherwise, remaining problems easy. But only these graph problems are difficult because you don't have practice of drawing the graph and exact points we have to plot and exactly we have to draw the curve, then only you will get the correct answer. In this case, no answer because it is not meeting the x-axis. That's all. So, three problems you practice, and again if you don't understand, tomorrow again you remind me in the chat box. Once again I will explain. Otherwise, Tomorrow we will go to the next model. So the graph problems will be over by today only. Tomorrow we will go to the other model. But if you don't understand, tomorrow I will again explain these problems. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.